I hate my job. I don't want to go to work this morning. No, you hate your job, quit your job. Get out of it. One life. We're not coming back.
Plus a whole lot of tree, fuck all this modesty. I just need space to do me, get a world what they're trying to see. A Stella Maxwell right beside of me. A Ferrari, I'm buying three. A closet of Saint Laurent, get what I want when I want, cause this hunger is driving me, yeah. I just need to be alone.
What is your handle? What is it?
Is it at Liam Barney?
Oh, I thought it was something for opening the door.
No, it's like you've got an app when you sign up for Twitter.
Oh, it's at Liam Barney 1978.
1978, that's not the year he was born in.
He chose that random. I know you wouldn't pick it.
That's still young Liam, in fairness. Memes are memes, right? Memes are memes, which is it? I think it's memes.
Yeah.
You think it's memes?
I think it's memes, yeah.
Can we have a vote? And one day, the most interesting day of the week, he follows me around, we create like a daily vlog.
Yeah, I saw that actually, and I saw your first one did quite well.
Yeah, I do
stalk everybody before I come
That's
in.
That's good.
Just have a little look at me.
Yeah, I'm just working out the best strategy for that at the moment, you know, kind of to...
And what is it you're hoping to do at the end of it? You're obviously trying to raise your own profile with a view to being a presenter or...
Not particularly, well, I suppose just kind of make myself a bit more of a public person and then ultimately to drive traffic back to the business as well.
Mm.
But like I do kind of a bunch of good individual things as well, like host shows and stuff.
Like that, just engage more with the people whose attention you're trying to grab.
Cool.
That would be my only other advice to you, because what you're doing quite well. I mean, you're lucky, you've got the skills, and a lot of people don't.
Right, that's good.
Have the skills. But I would say just maybe reach out now and start talking to people.
Cool.
It looks very good. You're doing well.
That's great feedback.
No problem.
I do value that
thing. And thanks for
This shit ain't random. I didn't get lucky. Made it right here because I'm sick with it. Cutty day. He was happy. She kind of said that we had some good content and stuff like that. So that's always great to hear from somebody who's managing, you know, a big brand like Dublin Airport. Taken away from that, she advised me to just engage a bit more with the followers, both on a personal capacity and a business point of view as well. So I mean that's good advice. I took away quite a bit from that. We're just heading back to the office now to have a quick meeting with Anthony in relation to upcoming events. It's a good day ahead. You're sick of hearing me saying that, but it's always good. Anything for a bit of PR. I'm charging you an ad fee for that.
You will when you get a letter from your solicitor.
If anything confidential goes on there, Anthony will be straight on to us.
Oh goodness.
Oh Jesus, he's not.
No.
It's time for lunch. Breakfast or lunch? It's breakfast. We're heading in to do a radio interview on Dublin City FM, something that happened as a result of what happened on episode one. So I'm looking forward to that. And we can on Snapchat now and see if anyone wants a shout out. First, let's get filled. So many times I don't know which way to go. What's up Snapchat, episode 3 of the daily vlog filming today. About to do a radio interview on Dublin City FM, a half one, 103.2, tune in. No different from the day before. That was quite a nice lunch. Nice ham, cheese, egg mayonnaise. I don't know, I think I'm gonna sing some country music when I get in here. Let me see what I've got. Baby, lock them doors and put them lights down low. It gets better for today. Come to your family. Let's do it. Danielle from episode one hypnotized me.
I loved the video.
Did you like it? Yeah, brilliant. Yeah. I enjoyed the hypnosis. It was good.
You've got the most amazing eyes.
Oh, thanks very much. Yeah.
He's great on camera.
I'll take that. You're quite good yourself as well. What does your show do?
Mind Matters. Uh-huh. The show to help you change your mind.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, so at 11 a.m. on Friday mornings. So we'll have to get you in and have a chat. Yeah,
love to
say you'd be interesting. Yeah.
Yeah.
You're really good on camera.
Thanks.
So you're not going to record all of this. Are you?
Yeah. No, every compliment.
Keep going, please.
Every compliment.
Give it all. Chase the world. First, chase the
dream. Hello.
Alright, so we're in Dublin City FM. We're about to go live with Kelly on Upstarts. Show starts at 1:30, so I'm really excited about that. This is the fourth time on the show. I can't believe how quickly this has come around. And, you know, we always have great banter. And it's actually part of something that happened on episode one. We're just getting offered the regular slot, so I'm going to be on the second Friday of every month. I'm really looking forward to the show, so let's go do it. Radio, I turned
off the radio. Martin, you are actually the expert in events. I mean, you've had a wide variety of experience. So what would be like your top 5 tips for anybody who is planning an event out there?
Sure. Yeah, well, I suppose there's a number of important things to consider that a lot of people actually don't, Kelly. I'm going to just run through 5 generic tips because I don't know what sort of events people are planning.
Sit, repeat that same hit song, upbeat and careless, like there ain't shit wrong, like there ain't lives lost, like there ain't lines crossed. Pray for change, not taking action, but you grip that cross.
I'll just give a shout out to Adam Madcore, who was probably listening down in Wexford or something like that. So, if you're watching this, Adam, I have your jeans from the last time I was down, and they're really comfortable, so you're not getting them back. That's pretty much it. And we might as well take the opportunity to wish him a happy 24th birthday. He's 21 in a few days, so I don't know what relevance that has to my day, but happy 24th birthday, Adam Madcore. We're late for the meeting.
Having too much crack.
We're having too much crack. We were literally in there strategizing ideas. Ended up staying in, I think it was an hour after the show ended, so let's just get back to the office. Update on the day, it's 3:30. We're not late for the meeting, we actually made it. So we're going to meet with a client now who have their wedding in early June. Just got back from Dublin City FM. We're going to finish this. We've got a bunch of phone calls to make, and then we're going to hit the road. We have to go to Westmead to do a site visit for a wedding that's taking place later this month. And that's how the day is looking so far. All in all, productive. Yes. So Mary has got her new desk there. She's wearing a blazer. Let's sneak up.
You were great.
Oh, you listened to it, did you?
It was great.
Okay. Mary Claire, yes. Mel Media. You missed it on the radio, but I missed your plug.
But the good news is we were having a chat with Kelly after the show went off air.
Yes.
And we were telling her all about you, plugging you to the noise. We love Mary Claire, master networker, and she has invited you onto the show.
Yes.
Win, cool, brilliant.
She's probably watching this now, actually, so hi Kelly, thanks for having
us on. Looking forward to seeing you.
Yeah, so you've got to get on there and do your thing.
Brilliant.
I do this for my father, who I've only seen from time to time in my
dreams. I do this for you. I do this for my... She interrupted the show. Yeah, I don't find the J's, those people.
I got you good there, didn't I? That's going to make a great content.
On the outtakes. Put me in the outtakes.
Outtakes.
Remember I promised chocolate?
You did.
Okay. He says, what are you doing with eggs? Eggs. Have you not had a chocolate egg?
Oh, God bless you.
There's like mocha. I washed the spoons. Okay. It's like, they're delish.
Mary, you're so good. Thanks a million.
No, the only reason I'm giving them to you is if I kept money.
I'm literally gonna make tea. I'm going to make a cup of tea. I still encounter it. It ain't something that a cigarette or alcohol can fix, but all because of it, I flipped it quick, went on to write some hits. This a success. Off another breath. This the first step in searching to be nothing less than be the best in what you do to prove their strength in being you. Learn so much in chasing dreams that I never would in school. Alright, so spent half an hour in a meeting at 4:30, which we couldn't film. So I think that's the first time it happened on the vlog, and that's quite interesting. Not everybody wants to be on camera. And just the hour after that, then just catching up on a few other things. So now we are on the way to Kinnegad to do a site visit on a wedding that's taking place later on this month. And we're going to get an idea of the layout of this room, see where the dance floor is going to go, see where everything else is going to go. Looking forward to getting in, getting a plan together, and that's it, moving back to Dublin. So off we go. Honestly, sounds fair to me. I'm pulling up to Costa for a quick takeaway coffee before we hit the road to Kinnegad. And the last time I was here, a friend of mine who I think is responsible for the facilities management over here warned me not to park on the double yellows. But we're in a real hurry, so Paul, if you're watching this, I'm really sorry. I have to get a coffee. That's why I do this for you. Do this for my mother, she'll be working for the summer. Two sets up their e-flow at the double bridge. It's not adapted to grow up in a home where I was treated like a problem. I don't know, it's just 8 o'clock. We're in Kinnegad. We're a beautiful village. That was a long ass drive. The coffee kept me going. Literally on 5 hours of sleep last night. Went to bed at 1, got up at 6. Got to DCU then. We were there from, 7:30 this morning?
Yeah.
So now this is pretty much the last meeting of the day. To come up out the town. Sorry, gotta stunt a little. Used to have my dreams belittled, but it's all a part of it. I know people's minds are fickle. Lines before. Like, it's 20 by 20, yes, when you put the edging and everything on,
yeah.
But the white part of the floor is like 18 by 18. Who I've only seen from time to time in my dreams. I do this for you. I do this for my mother, who's finally clean. You know, younger the thing. I do this for you. It's a queue of traffic coming up as well. We made it. Alright, that's it. I feel like this is about a right enough time to wrap things up here. So it's 8:30 at night. We're on the way back from Kinnegad in Westmead. We were at a venue called Harry's. Just Harry's of Kinnegad. So we're taking a site visit for a wedding that's taking place later on this month. And we were just checking out pretty much how the room was going to be set up. And we got a great idea of it, and that's pretty much all sorted, so I'm pretty happy about that. Overall, it was a really good day. We had some great crack all together. Loads of fun, loads of laughs, loads of productive tasks and meetings. So just happy that we really got a lot done today. And at any minute now, we're going to drop off Jamie at Lucan. Let him go off for the night because it's been a long day. And I am looking forward to continuing this. And that's it. I hope you enjoy watching. Thanks for watching. Appreciate your attention. If you got any value out of this, if you thought it was a bit of crack at all, we'd really appreciate a share. And until episode 4, thanks for watching. Everybody's gone, we're the last ones out. We're heading to a meeting in Alone.
Oh, it's the second. Jamie nearly killed me. The second time you nearly let me die.
This time too.